Hi, everyone. We're going to look at the book of Numbers, and we're going to look at chapter 21. And more specifically, we're going to look at why God had Moses lift up a bronze serpent on a pole. And let's just read those verses real quick and see what they're talking about that was going on then. And let's see how it applies to us today. We'll pick it up with verse 7. Therefore, the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against thee. Pray unto the Lord that he take away the serpents from us." And Moses prayed for the people. And the Lord said unto Moses, "Make thee a fiery serpent, and set it upon a pole. And it shall come to pass, that every one that is bitten, when he looketh upon it, shall live." And Moses made a serpent of brass, and put it upon a pole. And it came to pass, that if a serpent had bitten any man, when he beheld the serpent of brass, he lived. Okay, so what's going on there is that the children of Israel had worshipped Satan. Satan, many times in the scriptures, is described as being a serpent. If you look in Genesis, it talks about the serpent that deceived Adam and Eve. That's talking about the devil or Satan. If you look in Revelation, the book of Revelation, when it talks about the devil, it talks about the serpent, that old dragon, the devil. So the serpent in Numbers is a reference to the devil. And the children of Israel had worshipped the serpent. And the gift or the reward the serpent has in himself to give is death. Paul would say it this way, in Romans chapter 6, I think verse 23, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. And so what Paul's saying there is the reward that your own works will pay you with is death, but the gift that God has in himself to give is eternal life. And so the serpent, when you worship the serpent, it's not talking about falling down on your knees like you see in the TV, on TV. To worship the serpent means that you believe on his system for life. And if you read in Ezekiel, it describes Satan as a tree in the midst of the garden, and it says that it was the most beautiful tree, and it says that the tree looked to the river from which he had gotten life. And he had rejected the river from where he got in life and said that I will be exalted by using my ability to gather life to myself. And so if you look in Numbers, in fact, the verse 7 that we just read, it says that they spake against God. Well, if you read in Ezekiel, the serpent also spake against God. What that means is he rejected the life he could have from God, and he said, "I'm going to give myself life by my own works. My own works will be the food that I eat in order to try to have life." And so if you look in number 7, the children of Israel, they spake against God, meaning they rejected the life that God had in himself to give them. God had led them out of Egypt. And he had hedged them about with his life. He had served them with manna from heaven, which was him serving them with the bread that could feed them with life. He poured forth water out of the rock, which the Apostle Paul would later come and say that rock was a type and a shadow of Christ himself. And so God had life in himself to give the Israelites. And he was serving them with that life as a free gift. And it wasn't just any life. It was his very life. Well, the Israelites didn't want that life that God had in himself to give. They wanted the life that they had in Egypt, the life that they had from their own works. And so the Israelites wanted to make their own works their food for life, just like the serpent did. And so they were worshiping the serpent, and the gift that the serpent has to give is death. The serpent system pays people with death. And so what happened there was is that the Israelites were dying because the serpent had bit them with his death. And Moses, they prayed to Moses and they said, we've sinned and we spake against God. And God tells Moses, listen, man, I don't want these guys to die. I had given them my life as a gift this whole time, but they didn't want my life. They wanted the life that the serpent could give them. And so I let them have what they wanted. That's what it means when the scripture says that God sent the serpents. It doesn't mean that God is the father of the serpents. If you look in the Hebrew language there, when it says send, it means to let loose or for something to be loosed upon someone else. So when the Israelites didn't want God and they didn't want his life anymore and they wanted the life they could have from the serpent, God let them have what they wanted. In fact, you know, God can't keep people from what they want. He honors people as being a co-equal with him. He looks at people and he says, these people are in my image and my likeness. They're my kind. And I can't force my way on them. And in fact, 1 Corinthians 13, one of the things it says about love, and we know God is love, one of the things it says there is that love doesn't insist on its own way. So you could translate that or interpret that to say that God doesn't insist on his own way. So when the Israelites rejected God and rejected the life he had to give, and they wanted the life that came from the serpent system, God let them have what they wanted. And now, since the serpent only has death to give, the serpent was biting them with his death. And all the people were dying. And God tells Moses, Moses, fashion a bronze serpent and hang the bronze serpent up on the pole. And whoever can see the bronze serpent hanging on the pole, man, they'll be healed. They'll be healed from the death, meaning that they'll live and not die. Now, it's no accident why God had Moses fashion a bronze serpent, because bronze in the scriptures many times speaks of judging against something or condemning something. And so what God was doing is he was condemning the serpent and the serpent's bite of death that was killing the people. And so he crucified the serpent and the serpent's death that was killing the people up on the pole. And so what was going on there is he was putting the serpent's death to death. He was putting to death the serpent and the serpent's death so that the people could be healed from the death. And all the people that could see that serpent, the bite of the serpent nailed to the pole, would be healed from death. I love what the lead singer of U2 said, I think his name's Bono. I don't know. But he talked about going to Jerusalem and going to the place where Jesus died. And he says that he went to the place where death died, talking about Calvary, the place of the crucifixion. And so the hanging of the bronze serpent on the pole was a picture of God condemning death, judging against the serpent. And everybody who could see the death that had stung them, nailed to that pole, dying on that pole, they could see that they were dead to that serpent and dead to the bite of the serpent. They would be healed from death. Now, this wasn't just talking about something in the Old Testament. It was talking about something in the New Testament. Jesus said in the Gospel of John, he spoke about the just as Moses lifted up a serpent on the pole, so must the Son of Man be lifted up. And the scripture says that he said that, speaking of the death that he would die on the cross. Jesus goes on to say at another place in John's gospel, I think John chapter 12, that now is the time where the prince of this world will be judged. And he was talking about being lifted up on the pole or on the cross. So the prince of this world is the serpent or the dragon or the devil. And he reigned in this world through his death. His death reigned over all people. And Jesus talked about that now was going to come the time when he would be crucified on the cross, and he would take the bite of the serpent, which is the serpent's death, into his own body. And that would be God once again condemning the death that was condemning all of mankind. We were like the Israelites. We had walked out of the way. Paul says in Romans 3 that the poison of asps was under our tongue, meaning we had the serpent's message about the way into life under our tongue, just like the serpent said, that he would have life by his own works. We said, we will feed ourselves with life by our own works. And that was killing us. And so Jesus was lifted up on the pole. He was lifted up on the cross. And he took the bite of the serpent that was biting all of us. He took the death of the serpent that was killing all of mankind. And he took it into his own body on the cross so that God could condemn the death that was condemning us. So that all of us that could see God was with us, condemning the death that was condemning us inside of the flesh of the man Jesus. We could be healed from the bite of the serpent, or we could be healed from death, meaning we would be translated from the kingdom of the serpent's darkness into the kingdom of God's Son. We'd be translated from death to life. If you read in John chapter 16, speaking of the Holy Spirit coming and guiding us into all things that were revealed in Jesus. One of the things it says the Holy Spirit will guide us into is the fact that the prince of this world was judged. And that's talking about the serpent. And the serpent was judged on the cross. And his death was condemned on the cross inside of the flesh of Jesus. And that's what it means that Moses lifted up a bronze serpent on the pole. It's so that they could be healed from death. And it pointed to God sending his son, Jesus, in the likeness of sinful flesh, so that he could take the bite of the serpent, which was killing us, into himself. And through him taking that death into himself, he could take the death that was killing us into the grave. And we could see death crucified on the cross with him. We could see the death of death, actually, by beholding the cross. And everyone that can see the death of death, and they could see that they're dead to death and they're alive to God through Jesus. Man, they'll be healed from the bite of the serpent. Thank you so much for your time. I pray that this helps you in your study of the scriptures and your study of the serpent, the bronze serpent being lifted up on a pole. God bless.